Everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to teach you about the Lorentz force. So, Lorentz force means the net force experienced by the charge when it is placed in an electromagnetic field. Means when you take a charge and if you are placing that charge in an electromagnetic field, means where electric and magnetic both fields are present. So, in that region, if you place that charge, then that charge will experience both the forces, electric force as well as the magnetic force. So the net force experienced by that charge is called as the Lorentz force. So whenever a charge, if it is placed in electric field, it will experience the electric force. Means electric field will apply force on both the rest charge as well as the moving charge. But the magnetic field, if you place a charge in a magnetic field, it will apply the force only on the moving charge. It will not apply the force, means magnetic field will not apply force on the rest charge. So that we have already discussed in our last video about the magnetic force, what are its properties, what are its special properties, all those things we have studied. Here in this video we are going to deal with the Lorentz force. So first we will discuss about the electric field. So if you consider, this is our electric field. So in this electric field, if you place the charge Q, so what happens means on this charge Q, electric force will be applied and this charge will move in which direction, means in the direction of the electric field. So this charge will move in the direction of electric field with how much force, means QE amount of force. So if we talk about electric force, then we can write electric force is equals to Q into E. So this force will be applied on this charge if it is placed in the electric field. So if you take magnetic field, if you take here, this is our magnetic field which is inward, magnetic field is inward. So here if I place the charge Q which is moving with velocity V in this direction, so in this case force will be applied in this direction. So this is our direction of force. Magnetic field in the direction of inward, these fingers will shows the direction of magnetic field, thumb shows the direction of the motion of the charge, and the palm, where the palm is indicating, that is the direction of the force. So in this way the force will be applied. So if we want to calculate magnetic force, we'll write magnetic force is equals to QVB sine theta. We'll take QVB sine theta, or else this magnetic force can be written as Q of vector V cross vector B. So this is our electric force and this is our magnetic force. So if you combine electric and magnetic, means if you take electromagnetic field and in that region if you place the charge, then net force, we will call it as the Lorentz force. So we will write Lorentz force is equals to electric force plus magnetic force. So our electric force is how much? QE. Here we will write it as QE, plus magnetic force is Q vector V cross vector B. So in this case, if you take Q common, vector E plus vector V cross vector B. So this equation we will call it as the Lorentz force, or else we will call it as the net force experienced by the charge in an electromagnetic field. Means if both fields are present, electric field and magnetic field, if both fields are present and in that field if you are placing the charge, then that charge will experience two forces, electric force and magnetic force. So if you take the net force, if you calculate the net force, that is called as the Lorentz force. So next, after that we will discuss the different cases, means when electric field is parallel to magnetic field, when electric field is perpendicular to magnetic field. So so many different cases we will study. Main case is when electric field, magnetic field and charge, all these three are perpendicular to each other. So all these cases we will study one by one. So first we will take case one. In that case we will study when electric field and magnetic field both are parallel. So in that parallel only, again we will study by taking the rest charge, by taking moving charge, and by taking the charge which is moving parallel and which is moving perpendicular. So many cases we will study. So first we will deal with the parallel condition. So we will take here case one. So in case one, when electric field is parallel to magnetic field. So now if this is our electric field and this is our magnetic field, both the fields are parallel to each other. So in this field, if we are placing this Q charge, which is at rest, means this Q charge is at rest, then how the force will be applied on this charge? So if this is our rest charge, first if we talk about the electric force, then how much electric force is applied, means electric force is equals to QE. This QE amount of force will be applied on this rest charge, and this rest charge will move in which direction, means it will move in the direction of the electric field. In this direction the charge will be moving. And after that, if we talk about the acceleration, if it is moving means it is having some acceleration, so acceleration will take it as QE by M. M is the mass of this charge. So this is our acceleration. So acceleration is in which direction, means x direction. So if you consider, this is x direction and this is y direction, so the charge will move in this x direction. So acceleration is in x direction. Next, if we talk about velocity, if this charge is in motion, means it is having some velocity. So if we talk about velocity, then how to calculate, means v is equals to u plus at. So here velocity is in which direction? In x direction. Initial velocity, how much will take? Initial velocity will take it as 0, because this charge is at rest. So this is 0 plus acceleration is QE by M into T. So this is the velocity. So next, if we talk about magnetic force, we are having the formula, magnetic force is equals to QVB sin theta. So in this case, V is what? Velocity. So here what is the velocity of this charge? Velocity will be 0 because charge is at rest. So because of this condition, because of the charge is at rest, our force will become 0, because velocity is 0. So again, if one question come to your mind, that if this charge is in motion because of this electric field, because this is applying some force on this charge and it is having acceleration, velocity, because of that this charge is in motion, then why magnetic field is not, why we are taking magnetic field 0? So our answer is, suppose if this charge is in motion because of this electric field, then this charge is in motion, this charge is moving parallel to magnetic field. If this charge is moving parallel to magnetic field, again here theta value will becomes 0. Parallel means theta is 0. So here if you substitute theta value as 0, again sine 0 will be 0. So again force we will get it as 0. So how much electric force will be applied, means QV amount of force will be applied because of this electric field, and magnetic force is 0. Because condition we have studied that magnetic force, magnetic field will apply force only on the moving charge, but condition is what? It should not move in the direction of the magnetic field. So this is our first case. So next we will take same case only, we'll write here case 2. In this case also both fields will take it as parallel, but here we will take moving charge. In this case also both the fields are parallel. This is electric field and this is magnetic field. Here also the both the fields are parallel, but here we will take the charge Q, which is in motion in the direction of both the fields. Means this charge Q is moving parallel to both electric field and the magnetic field. With how much velocity? With V naught velocity. So how much force will be applied on this charge, that we will discuss. So first we will talk about electric force. So electric force, how much it is applied, means QE. Electric force will be how much? QE. Next, if we talk about acceleration, acceleration is also in x direction. Again it is QE by M. Velocity U plus AT. Here initial velocity is how much? Initial velocity is V naught, because charge is in motion. So here we will take it as V naught plus acceleration is QE by M into T. So this is our velocity, and this velocity is in which direction? So velocity is in the x direction. So this is all about the electric force. Next we will talk about magnetic force. So magnetic force, we are having the formula QVB sin theta. So here theta value, how much you will take? Theta value, this is the direction of the charge and this is the magnetic field. Both are parallel. Parallel means theta value will be 0. So again sin 0 value will become 0. Means magnetic force, how much we got? Magnetic force is 0. So in this case, charge will move in the direction of the electric field and it will move in the straight line. Here also the charge is moving in the straight line. In this case also magnetic force is 0 and here also the magnetic force is 0. Next, third case we will study about if the charge is moving perpendicular to both the field. Third case we will study in case 3, charge is perpendicular. So this is our electric field and this is our magnetic field. So here this is our Q charge and this Q charge is moving perpendicular to both the field, electric field and magnetic field. For both the fields this charge is moving perpendicular. So this charge, how much force is experiencing? So first we'll talk about electric force. So our electric force will be F is equals to QE. And next, after that, if we talk about acceleration, acceleration is QE by M. Next, if we talk about velocity, velocity is U plus AT. Initial velocity, how much will take? Initial velocity will take it as 0 because this charge is moving perpendicular. It is not moving in the direction of electric field. So for that reason, here our initial velocity will be 0. Acceleration will be QE by M. And this is T. And next, acceleration is in which direction? Means this charge, if it is moving in this direction, but because of this electric field, this charge will tends to move in this direction. Means it will align in the direction of the electric field. So for that reason, acceleration is applied in x direction and velocity is also in the x direction. So this is about the electric force. Next, we will talk about magnetic force. So magnetic force, we are having the formula QVB sin theta. Here theta value, how much you will take? Theta value will take it as 90 degree because this charge is moving perpendicular to magnetic field. Perpendicular means theta value will be 90. Sin 90 will be 1. So here we'll get it as QVB. So this is the maximum force applied on this charge Q. And in this case, when the charge is moving perpendicular to magnetic field, means this charge will move in the circular path, because in this case the magnetic force will acts like a centripetal force for this charge. So for that reason, here it will move in the circular path. Charge will move in the circular path, and because of this electric force it will move in the linear path. So linear plus circular will becomes helical path. Helical path means the charge will move in like this. Means this charge will move in linear direction also and as well as in the circular path also. Circular because of the magnetic force, linear because of the electrical force. So combination of linear and circular path, it will becomes the helical path. But this pitch will be uneven. So here we'll write helical path with uneven pitch. Why pitch is uneven? Means the distance will becomes increases, so like this. Means this distance we'll call it as the pitch, and this pitch will be increases, so it is uneven. So uneven pitch is because of the electric field. Because of this electric field, charge will be, means velocity of that charge will be increases in the linear motion, but magnetic force will not increase the velocity of the charge. Velocity is increased only by the electric field. So this is our third case. Next, we will study about the fourth case. In fourth case, we will take any arbitrary angle. Arbitrary angle means charge will be moving neither perpendicular nor parallel to magnetic field. So case 4. So in case 4, this is our electric field and this is our magnetic field. Any arbitrary angle you take, arbitrary angle means this is our charge Q, and this charge Q is moving like this with velocity V naught. Means this charge is neither moving perpendicular to both the field nor it is moving parallel to both the fields. So in this case, if you consider this is imaginary line theta, this is our angle theta. So next, in this case, this velocity vector we will resolve into two component, one parallel component and one perpendicular component. So this parallel component we will take it as V naught cos theta, and one perpendicular component we will call it as V naught sin theta. This vector resolved into two component. So next, how much force is applied on this charge? So to calculate that, first we'll talk about the electric force. Electric force, how much will be applied? That is QE. And next, acceleration is equals to QE by M. Next, velocity is how much? Velocity is equals to U plus AT. Initial velocity, what you will take? Initial velocity, you will take this component because electric field is applied in the direction of the electric field. So this component will take it as initial velocity, that is V naught cos theta, plus acceleration is QV by M multiplied by T. So this is the velocity. Next, after that, if we talk about magnetic force. So magnetic force, we are having the formula, that is QVB sin theta. So here velocity, how much will take? V naught. So this magnetic force is because of which component? Means because of V naught sin theta component. Because of this component, electric field is applied. Because of this component, magnetic field is applied. So this is our magnetic force. So in this case, the charge wants to move in the circular path. So here I will write circular path, and in this case it will move in the straight line path. So in this case also, if you combine both straight line and circular, so here I will write linear plus circular, again it will move in the helical path. Means because of this electric field, velocity of this charge will goes on increasing. Means the charge will move with velocity V naught cos theta. Means charge's velocity will be increasing, and because of this V naught sin theta component, the charge will makes the circular path. Circular as well as linear, circle will goes on increasing in the forward direction. So for that it will makes the helical path. So like that it will travel. So this distance we will call it as the pitch, and this pitch is also uneven. So if you consider this is pitch 1 and this is P2 and this is P3. So pitch 1 is smaller, this pitch will goes on increasing. So question arises, when this pitch will be even? Here it is uneven. When it will be even means, if you take this electric field 0, if you make this electric field 0, then what happens means this charge will not move in the linear direction. So in that case it will be even. But because of this electric field, what happens means velocity of this charge will goes on increasing. So because of that increasing velocity, this pitch will be increases. So we'll call it as the helical path with uneven pitch. Helical path with uneven pitch. One condition you have to remember, that the velocity of this charge is increased only because of the electric field. Magnetic field is not responsible for the velocity of the charge. Means magnetic field will not increase the velocity of the charge. It can only change the direction of that charge. Means it can change only the motion of that charge. Direction it will change, velocity it will not affect. Means it will not increase or decrease. So this is all about the four cases about how the charge will be experience force when it is placed in the electric and magnetic field when both the fields are parallel. In next video, we are going to discuss about when electric field and magnetic field both are perpendicular to each other. And again, very very important concept is when electric field, magnetic field and charge, all these three are moving perpendicular to each other, and that case we'll call it as the velocity selector. That is a very important case that we will discuss in our next video. So stay tuned.